This is based on a true story. Once a violinist went to a metro station in New York. He sat on a bench and started playing the violin. It was a cold and busy Friday morning. Thousands of people were passing through the metro station. The violinist played 6 to 7 musical pieces for an hour. None of the people passing by even noticed him playing. Most of them were on their way to work. One old person stopped by the violinist and listened to his music. But he didn't even listen to a single musical piece totally. After playing for quite some time, the violinist received his first tip. The woman who tipped the violinist didn't even stop and listen to music. She just threw the money in his hat and left. After some time, a 3-year-old kid was passing with his mother. The kid stopped for a while to listen to the violinist. But his mother was in a hurry. She scolded the kid for wasting the time and pushed him to continue walking. The kid looked fascinated by the music, but his mother was in a hurry. He was continuously turning his head to see the violinist as he left with his mom. The same thing happened with a few more kids, but their parents forced them to move on. The violinist played for an hour, but only 7 people stopped and listened to for a few minutes. About 15 people put money into his bag. He collected around $30. When he was done playing the violin, there was a silence at the metro station, but nobody even noticed that. Neither the violinist was applauded, nor anyone heard his music properly. No one even knew this, but the violinist was no other than Joshua Bell. He was one of the best musicians in the world. He played one of the most expensive musical pieces ever written with a violin on the station. That musical piece was worth around $3.5 million. 2 days before this incident on the subway, a show of Joshua Bell was sold out. The show was in Boston and the cost of a single seat was $100. This is a true story. Washington Post had organized this event in the metro station with Joshua Bell. It was a social experiment to acknowledge and determine the taste, perception, and priorities of people. The show was organized at Common Place with lots of people at an unusual hour. The results were shocking, made everyone think, how do we judge things? How do we acknowledge beauty? We seem to concentrate on something when we are paying for it. Most of those people in the metro station would agree to pay to hear Joshua Bell's music live, but they were too busy to notice the musician. They didn't care about music. It makes me wonder, how many beautiful things like this do we ignore or forget to enjoy in our daily life? There are a lot of beautiful things that happen daily in our life. Do we stop and take time to appreciate people? Do we stop and take time to appreciate the little things in life? Do we appreciate the musician for his talent or his name? How many of us pause our busy routine and focus on people around us? So many people on that metro station missed the chance to enjoy famous Joshua Bell's music that day for free. Like this, we are missing out on many things in life because of the rat race environment. This incident took place on the morning of 12 January 2007.